Good morning. It's Carol at Carol-WDWAO. Today I'm really excited about our day, so I hope you join us. Hey everyone, today is going to be a very different day. We're leaving the Disney bubble. I know, shocking, but it's happening. And we're going with Dan and David. So who knows what that will bring, because he's crazy and David doesn't do much to keep him in check. And we're going on an Everglades tour. So Everglades outfit, very, very casual. Then we get back, we go to Hollywood Studios for just a brief short time. We'll see what today brings. I can't guarantee anything that I can show you, because with Dan it's probably X-rated, because he's just a wild man, but we'll see what happens.
Well, you're in the trouble before you guys already.
You guys are trouble.
Oh, he's getting outside.
That's okay.
Don't listen to anything they said about me.
Either that or they're all at the airport.
Did you have a hard time coming through the gate?
Yeah, they wanted me to your
just
surname.
Your name.
Yep.
That was it.
So this is where we get the airboat. Nice little shack here. You check in. This is the alligator that scared the pants off of Dan. I wish I had my camera on for his reaction. We just sort of walked out and he said, oh look, there's an alligator. And his reaction was priceless. Okay, Dan's always teasing me about bathrooms, but this is the weirdest sink I've ever seen. So to get it to work, it's not a solar, you know, a hand motion thing. You have to press this little lever to get it to work. So that's pretty weird. So Dan, I did just go into the restroom.
Oh, no,
we're having dueling cameras.
Here she comes.
So I'm joining the group there. And we're going over to the dock to see Captain Logan. Nice little park. I don't know exactly where we are. We Ubered it. Dan picked us up at Hop. It was about $42. And 45 minutes it took us to get here. Oh, and I see a boat coming in. So this might be the boat that we're going out on, perhaps.
Here she comes.
There's Dan.
Look at me vlogging you, vlogging me.
Yeah, I know.
You little vlogger. Oh.
Yeah. So I do see earmuffs on here. I have heard that the airboats do get a little noise. I did bring some ear protection for all of us, but it looks like they provide it. So I'm expecting to hear some noise. But I see microphones in there, so I'm wondering if she's going to narrate as she takes us.
Might be like a helicopter.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you guys did a helicopter when you went to Brazil, right?
Yeah, we did one in Rio and one over Iguazu Falls. Yeah, just incredible. The one over Rio was just insane.
Yeah, yeah, and I will make sure I link that so people can see, because some of those pictures that you guys had were fabulous. So
it's amazing.
Yeah.
Science constantly.
So cool.
So safety. They are sanitizing the ear sets and headsets. That's good to know. Safety is always important. So sanitizing everything.
There's an air horn and a map of the lake. On this side of my captain seat down low is a big red throw ring. Coast Guard regulations specifically state that as your captain, if at any point in this tour any one of you go overboard, I'm legally required to throw that to you for basically just for safety. Regulation specifically states that I'm legally required to haul you back in. We'll put that to a vote, so just be nice to everybody around you. Down low under my seat, I've also got a paddle, an anchor, and a manual bilge pump. Then right here up front, these are going to be your emergency contacts just in case anything happens to me out there today. Does anybody have any questions for me?
No, thank you.
No.
Well, good. The best news about all that safety stuff is I don't plan on using any of it. I got you guys out here for an hour and a half. Gives us plenty of time to cruise around the lake, do a little bit of sightseeing. I'm going to try to find you guys some nature and wildlife to look at. Just please keep in mind, everything out here is just that. This is nature. This is wildlife. I don't have any control over what you're going to see today, but anything cool we come across, I will take full credit for. You're more than welcome to have your cameras out. Take as many photos, as many videos as you want. Have a good time out here, but please secure them. I'm not going to be responsible if they go overboard, and also please do not... West Lake Tehopakealiga.
Can you say that again?
West Lake Tehopakealiga.
I can't repeat that.
I always give a big high five ready for anybody who can spell that.
T-O-H-A-Q-A.
No, that. T-H-A-T. Tehopakealiga is a little bit of a mouthful with the locals. We keep it nice and simple, and we all just call it West Lake.
West Lake.
Oh, well, that we can all do.
Get their name because of the funny way that they walk, kind of have a little Jack Sparrow in their walk to them.
What are they called, sir?
A limpkin.
Limpkin.
Pretty medium sized bird, mostly brown with some white spots. They got that long curved beak. That's one of many of the bird species out here that feast on those apple snails, but they're likely to eat small fish, small insects, mussels, just about anything that they can come across out here that they can either get out of a shell or swallow whole. Actually spend most of their time underwater.
Snake bird.
snake bird is exactly right. It's faster under the water. They can actually outrun some of the small fish that they prey on, and they have that real long neck and that pointy beak. They'll just cock that back to their body. As they get close to their prey, they'll shoot it forward to stab it. And you'll see them pop their head just barely up out of the water. They'll toss that little fish up in the air, snap it, swallow it down, and then go right back to hunting. It doesn't help them so much when they want to fly, which is why it's pretty typical to see them perched up on the vegetation. Just like this, they'll spread their bodies out and just kind of try to air themselves out on a light breeze and try to get themselves dried off. So they'll be like... I haven't seen one of these birds in years, and there's
What's that? Two of them.
The
egret?
You guys are going to have to stand up.
And they are one of the ones where they collected the eggs and replaced the eggs and hand-reared eggs and put them back out. And so they are still an endangered species.
They're still federally protected. They might be a little bit harder to see because they blend in a little bit better, but you see several birds over here, these gray birds with the bright red foreheads.
Yeah.
Those are sandhill cranes, but those two white ones are whooping cranes.
Find your mouth. That'll make the outtakes video.
Okay.
So what do you think, Dan? Wasn't it amazing?
Do you know what, right? I would never have done this had it not been for David wanting to do like an Everglades tour. And as I said to you earlier, I left it on the camera, if I said to you, he wanted to go down and do the actual National Everglades
right.
Park, and it was too far. For this trip, we had so much already planned, so many people come in and wanting to see them.
Yeah.
So. I found this as a kind of alternative, and
then you invited us along.
I invited you along, and I wasn't sure if this was going to be any good. In fact, in my trip announcement, I said this might be a bit rubbish. I didn't use the word rubbish, but this is a family channel, so. But I said it might be a bit rubbish, and I'd let you know. And honestly, I think it was really good. I'm really glad we did it.
It was amazing. Just the vegetation and. I was amazed at, it looks like there's mud and dirt and we cross right over. So it's, the airboat was really cool. It was my first airboat ride. The vegetation was beautiful. You got a nice breeze when it was going. We saw a few birds along the way, but then we saw Captain Logan get excited. How many of these boat tours does he do? He might do like six a day, and
yeah.
You know. And he was like, all right, your captain's about to freak out. And we're like, something wrong with the boat, what's going on? And
no, I wasn't thinking that.
And we saw whooping cranes. Endangered, endangered, endangered whooping cranes. He said this was the first time he's seen them since he was a kid. So it was, you couldn't Disney magic this.
And he must be in his late 30s, would you say?
Yeah.
Late 30s, early 40s, maybe?
No, I wouldn't say 40, I would
say 30. Yeah, late 30s, and he hasn't seen them since he was a kid.
Yeah.
And he lives here and does this all the time,
yep.
So.
Yep. And then another boat captain pulled up right alongside, which they try and keep distance from each other, because it was that cool of a unique magic moment. We were so lucky. It's worth the whole trip just for that moment.
It's particularly for science teachers. I'm a little bit disappointed we didn't get to see any alligators.
Yeah.
I saw an alligator.
Did you?
Through my camera.
Did you?
I did.
Okay.
Oh, I didn't.
I didn't see an alligator.
We saw that alligator.
We saw that plastic one over
there. Yeah, the one that Dan got scared at. Yeah, you would have jumped out of the boat if you saw a real one, so it's probably good we didn't see one.
Yeah, well, I've seen them before at the Everglades National Park. I've seen them before.
But I really wanted David to see the alligators, but we didn't get to today. But that probably means we have to do this again at some point. Or we go to the real Everglades Park. But yeah, no, it was really good. It was about, we paid for it in pounds sterling because I booked it in the UK. And it worked out to be about $88 with the conversion rate per person. I think that was worth the money.
Oh yeah, definitely.
We gave Logan a nice tip because he was really good.
And especially since you bought my ticket for me, it was really worth the money for me.
Yeah.
And I don't know why you did that, because I wasn't that much of a pain in your butt.
No, it was a gift to say thank you for everything you've done for WWAO.
Well, thank you.
You're very welcome. I just hope I don't become one of the lifeguards. He starts stalking me.
How do you know I'm not stalking you?
That's true. You're following us to Hollywood Studios now.
Dan has given a great tip. I give credit where credit is due. If you want more than one soft drink over here at Backlot Express, you can refill your sodas. And it's free, you know, you're not going against anything. So that's Dan's tip for the day. He's good for one. I don't have a lot of tips at Hollywood Studios because I'm old school, and when they got rid of lights, camera, action, and
sleep and action,
Daniel, and they got rid of Catastrophe Canyon and moved everything around, I always get discombobulated in this back area. I'm good at Toy Story Land, I'm good Tower of Terror, I'm good at Star Wars, but this back area here, I'm always very confused. And especially since Star Tours is not anywhere near Galaxy's Edge. So that always confuses me. Oh, and
we're going to the restroom.
And he always makes fun of me for videoing. I'm not going to follow him in there.
So here's your Mickey cart. They used to have gelato over here. Oh, here's the gelato cart. And we're heading into. Can we see Miss Piggy? Oh, Miss Piggy is missing. Hi, Kermit.
Hi, old Kermit the Frog here. Nice to meet you, Miss.
Pleased to meet you too. I like your official tag there that says Kermit from Leland, Mississippi. You got an accent, Kermit? No? No accent. Picking up standby.
Sometimes you can't even stay. Get away and have the perfect day. We'll sing a song, and absolutely nothing will go wrong. Oh.
Does anybody here know a handyman? Are there any dads in the audience pretending to be handymen at home?
Thank you. three, one, two, three. Oh, excellent! You're all waltzing so beautifully together. Now, let's conga!
Well, that concludes my guided tour of Japan, waltzing right around the park. Why, picnickers, told you nothing was gonna go wrong.
First time,
oh, it was just fun. I mean, and I love the animation, I love the colors, the special effects, you know, and it was just fun. It's over, they're always over too quick though.
Yeah,
for me.
Yeah,
it's just like, oh no, I want it to go on for 5 more minutes.
Yep, but then think of how long the lines would be.
I know, so get a taste.
I still miss the Great Movie Ride, but this is cute. We are off to the pool. We've got dinner at Monsieur Paul, so we're going to pool just shortly, clean up, because, you know, and then we're expecting an excellent dinner. Hope you stay with us.
Please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Hit that notification bell so you know when new videos land. We have an adult-only Facebook group, WDWAO. Look for us there for more discussions about things like this. And last but not least, never grow up.